guess she's all right. She really shouldn't drink. She's very frail. Slim-hipped, as you would have it. I'm really very sorry.
Where is my little yum-yum? Where's Martha?
She's making coffee in the kitchen. She gets sick quite easily.
Martha? Oh, Martha hasn't been sick a day in her life, unless you count the time she spends in the rest home.
No, my wife. My wife gets sick quite easily. Your wife is Martha.
Oh, I know.
She doesn't spend any time in a rest home.
Your wife?
No, yours.
Oh, mine. No, she doesn't. I would, though. I mean, I would if I were her. She. But I'm not, so I don't. I'd like to, though. It gets pretty bouncy around here sometimes.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Well, you saw an example of it.
Well, I try not to...
Get involved, is that right?
Yes, that's right.
Yeah, I'd imagine not.
Well, I find it embarrassing. Oh, you do?
Huh?
Yes, really. Quite. Yes, really. Quite.
Disgusting.
Now, look, I didn't have anything to do with
you. You think I like that, whatever it is, coming in here and tearing me down, humiliating me in front of you? You think I care for that?
No, I don't imagine you care for it at all.
Oh, you don't imagine?
No, I don't. I don't imagine you do.
Well, your sympathy disarms me. Your compassion makes me weep. Large, salty, unscientific tea.
I just don't see why you feel you have to subject other people to it.
I?
If you and your wife want to go at each other like
I,
a couple
why,
of...
I want to.
Animals, why don't you do it when there's no one here?
Smug, self-righteous little...
Now you can it, mister. You watch that.
Scientist?
Boy, I never hit an older man.
Oh, only younger men. Children, women, birds, eh? Well, you're quite right. It isn't the prettiest spectacle, watching a couple of middle-aged types hacking away at each other, getting all red in the face and winded, missing half the time.
Oh, you two don't miss. You two are pretty good. It's impressive.
Oh, and impressive things impress you. You're easily impressed. A sort of pragmatic idealism, huh?
No, it's just that sometimes I can admire things that I don't admire. Now, flagellation is not my idea of good times, but...
But you can admire a good flagellator, a real pro.
Uh-huh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Your wife throws up a lot, huh?
I didn't say that. I said she gets sick quite easily.
Oh, I thought by sick you meant...
Well, it's true. She does throw up a lot. I mean, once she starts, there's practically no stopping her. She'll go right on for hours. Not all the time, you know, but regularly.
You can sort of tell time by her, huh?
Yeah, almost.
Drink.
Yes. I married her because she was pregnant.
Oh? I thought you didn't have any kids. When I asked you, you said...
Well, she wasn't, actually. It was a hysterical pregnancy. She blew up, and then she went down.
And while she was up, you married her.
Yeah, and then she went down.
Bourbon is right.
Yeah, that's right, bourbon.
When I was 16, going to prep school during the Punic Wars, a bunch of us used to go into New York on the first day of vacation before we fanned out to our homes. And in the evening, this bunch of us used to go to this gin mill owned by the gangster father of one of us. For this was during the Great Experiment, or Prohibition, as it is more frequently called. And it was a bad time for the liquor lobby and a fine time for the crooks and the cops. And we'd go to this gin mill, and we'd drink with the grown-ups and listen to the jazz. And one time in the bunch of us, there was this boy who was 15 who had killed his mother with a shotgun some years before. Accidentally, quite accidentally, without even an unconscious motivation, I have no doubt at all. And this one evening, this boy went with us. And when we ordered our drinks, and when it came his turn, he said, "I'll have Bergen. Give me some Bergen, please. Bergen and water." Well, we all laughed. And he was blonde, and he had the face of a cherub, and we all laughed. And his cheeks went red, and the color rose in his neck. And the assistant crook who had taken our order told people at the next table what the boy had said, and then they laughed. And then more people were told, and the laughter grew. and more people and more laughter. And no one was laughing more than us, and none of us more than the boy who had shot his mother. And soon everyone in the gin mill knew what the laughter was about, and everybody started ordering Bergen and laughing when they ordered it. And soon, of course, the laughter became less general, but it did not subside entirely for a very long time. For always at this table or at that, somebody would order Bergen, and a new area of laughter would rise. Ah, we drank free that night. We were brought champagne by the management, by the gangster father of one of us. And, of course, we all suffered the next day, each of us alone on his train away from New York, each of us with his grown-up's hangover. But it was the grandest day of my youth.
Thank you. What happened to the boy who shot his mother?
I won't tell you.
All right.
The following summer, on a country road, with his learner's permit in his pocket and his father on the front seat to the right of him, he swerved his car to avoid a porcupine and drove straight into a large tree.
No.
He was not killed, of course. And in the hospital, when he was conscious and out of danger, and they told him that his father was dead, he began to laugh, I have been told. And his laughter grew and would not stop. And it was not until after they had jammed a needle into his arm, not until after that, not until after he felt consciousness slipping from him, that his laughter subsided, stopped. And when he was recovered from his injuries, enough so that he could be moved without damage should he struggle, he was put into an asylum. That was 30 years ago.
Well, is he, still there?
Oh, yes. And I am told that in these 30 years, he has not uttered one sound. Martha! Martha!
I told you, she's making coffee.
For your hysterical wife who goes up and down.
Went up and down.
Went? No more?
No more. Nothing.
The saddest thing about men, well, no, one of the saddest things about men is the way they age, some of them. Do you know what it is with insane people? Do you? The quiet ones?
No.
They don't change. They don't grow old.
They must.
Well, eventually, probably, yes, but they don't in the usual sense. They maintain a firm-skinned serenity. The underuse of everything leaves them quite whole.
Are you recommending it?
No, but some things are sad, though.
Yep.
But you just gotta buck up and face it, that's all. You just gotta buck up. Martha doesn't have hysterical pregnancies.
My wife had one.
Yes. Martha doesn't have pregnancies at all.
No, I don't imagine she does now. Do you have any other kids? Do you have any daughters or anything?
Do we have any what?
Do you have any? I mean, you only have one kid, your son.
Oh, no, just one. Just the one boy, our son.
Well, that's nice.
Yes, well, he's a real comfort. A beanbag.
A what?
A beanbag. Beanbag. Oh, you wouldn't understand. Beanbag.
I heard you. I didn't say I was deaf. I said I didn't understand.
You didn't say that at all.
Well, I meant I was implying I didn't understand, for Christ's sake.
You're getting testy.
Well, I'm sorry.
All I do is mention that our son, the apple of our three eyes, Martha being a cyclops, is a beanbag, and you get testy.
Well, I'm sorry. I'm tired. And it's late. I've been drinking since 9 o'clock. My wife's been vomiting. There's a lot of screaming going on around here.
And you're testy. Well, don't worry about it. Anybody who comes here ends up getting testy. It's expected. Don't be upset.
I'm not upset.
You're testy.
Yes.
Oh, I wanted to set you straight about something while the little ladies are still out of the room.
I wanted to set you straight about something Martha said.
Oh, well, now, look, I don't make judgments, so don't feel like you have
to... I want to tell you anyway. No, I know you don't like to become involved. I know that you like to preserve your scientific detachment in the face of, well, for lack of a better word, life and all. But all the same, I'd like to tell you.
Well, I'm a guest. Go right ahead.
Oh, well, now, that makes me feel all warm and runny inside.
Now, look, if you're going to start that stuff again...
Ah, forest sounds.
Huh?
Animal noises.
Hey!
Oh. Ah, nursing.
Can't. We're sitting up, we're having coffee, but we'll be back.
Well, look, is there anything I should do?
Yeah, just sit here and listen to George's side of things. Bore yourself to death.
Monstre!
Cochon?
Bête!
Canaille?
Putain!
Yeah. You two types amuse yourself. We'll be back. Did you clean up the mess you made, George?
No, Martha, I did not clean up the mess I made. I have been trying for years to clean up the mess I made.
Have you?
Hmm?
Have you been trying for years?
Accommodation, malleability, adjustment, these do seem to be in the order of things, don't they?
Now look, don't try to put me in the same class with you.
Oh, no, no, of course not. Things are simpler for you. You marry a woman because she's all blown up, while I and my clumsy old person...
Oh, there was more to it than that.
Sure, I bet she had money, too.
Yes.
Yes? Yes? You mean I was right? I hit it?
Well, you see...
By God, what archery. First try, too. How about that?
Oh, you see...
There were other things.
Yes.
To compensate.
Yes.
There always are. No, I'm sure there are. I didn't mean to be flip. There are always compensating factors, as in the case of Martha and myself. Now, on the surface of it, it appears to
me. I mean,
be
we sort of grew up together, you know?
On the surface of it.
I mean, we knew each other from.
Back when I.
God, I don't know, from the time we were six or something.
Back there. Well, even before.
I'm sorry.
Oh, no, I'm sorry.
No, go ahead.
No, you go ahead.
No, please.
No, I insist. You're the guest. You go first.
Well, hell, it seems sort of silly now.
Nonsense. But if you were six, she must have been four or something.
Well, maybe I was eight. She was six. We used to play doctor.
Well, that's a good, healthy, heterosexual beginning.
Yep.
The scientist even then, huh?
Yep. Yeah, it was always taken for granted, you know, by our families. And by us, too, I suppose. So we did.
Did what?
We got married.
When you were eight?
No, much later.
Oh, I wonder.
I wouldn't say there was any particular passion between us even at the beginning. Of our marriage, I mean.
Well, no great surprise. No earth-shaking discoveries after doctor and all, huh?
No.
I mean, it's all pretty much the same anyway, no matter what they say about Chinese women, eh?
And what is that?
Oh, here, let me freshen up your glass.
Oh, boy, after a while, you don't get any drunker, do you?
Well, you do, but it's different. Everything slows down. You get sodden. Unless you can upchuck like your little wife, then you can sort of start all over again.
Boy, everybody drinks a lot here in the East. Everybody drinks a lot in the Middle West, too.
Well, we drink a great deal in this country. And I suspect we shall be drinking a great deal more. If we survive, we should be Arabs or Italians. The Arabs don't drink, and the Italians don't get drunk much except on religious holidays. We should go and live on Crete or something.
Well, that, of course, would make us Cretans.
So it would. Well, tell me about your wife's money.
Why?
Oh, well, don't then.
What do you want to know about my wife's money for, huh?
Well, I thought it'd be nice.
No, you didn't.
All right. I want to know about your wife's money because I'm fascinated by the methodology, by the pragmatic accommodation by which you wave of the future boys are going to take over.
You're starting in again.
Am I? No, I'm not. Listen, Martha's got money, too. Her father has been robbing this place blind for years.
No, he hasn't. He has not.
He has?
No.
Very well. Martha's father has not been robbing this place blind for years, and Martha doesn't have any money, okay?
We're talking about my wife's money, not yours.
Okay, talk.
No. My father-in-law was a man of the Lord. And he was very rich.
What faith?
My father-in-law was called by God when he was six or something. And he started preaching and he baptized people and he saved them. And he traveled around a lot and he got to be pretty famous. Oh, well, not like some of them, but pretty famous. And when he died, he had a lot of money.
God's money?
No, his own.
Well, what happened to God's money?
He spent God's money. He saved his own. He built hospitals and he sent off mercy ships and he brought the people outdoors into the sun. And he brought the outhouses indoors. And he built three churches, or whatever they were. And two of them burned down, and he ended up pretty rich.
Well, I think that's very nice.
Yeah. So, my wife's got some money.
But not God's money.
No, her own.
Well, I think that's very nice.
Yeah.
Well, Martha's got money, too, because Martha's father's second wife, not Martha's mother, but after Martha's mother died, was a very old lady with warts who was very rich.
She was a witch.
But she was a good witch. And she married the white mouse with the tiny red eyes. And he must have nibbled away at her warts or something like that. Because she went up in a puff of smoke almost immediately. Poof, poof, poof. And all that was left, aside from some wart medicine, was a big fat will, a peach pie, with some for the township in New Carthage, and some for the college, and some for Martha's father, and just this much for Martha.
Hey, you know, The witch with the warts and my father-in-law should have gotten together, because he was a mouse, too.
He was?
Yeah, he was a church mouse. Hey. Your wife never mentioned a stepmother.
Well, maybe it isn't true.
Well, maybe it is.
Yeah, it might be, it might not. But I think your story's a whole lot nicer about your pumped-up little wife and your father-in-law who was a priest.
He was not a priest. He was a man of God.
Yes.
And she was not pumped up. She blew up.
Yes, yes.
Well, get things straight.
Well, I'm sorry. I will. I'm sorry. Of course, you realize that I'm drawing you out on all this stuff, not because I am interested in your terrible lifehood, but because you represent a direct and pertinent threat to my lifehood, and I want to get the goods on you.
Sure, sure.
I mean, I warned you. You stand warned.
I stand warned. Boy, it's you sneaky types that worry me the most. You ineffectual sons of bitches. You the worst.
Oh, yes, we are. Sneaky. An elbow in your steely blue eyes and a knee in your solid gold groin. We're the worst.
Yeah.
Well, I'm glad you don't believe me, and I know that you've got history on your side and all.
No, you got history on your side. I got biology on my side. Yeah, history and biology.
Yeah, I know the difference.
Well, you don't act it.
No? I thought we decided that you were going to take over the history department before you took over the whole work, sort of a step at a time.
Oh, what I thought I'd do. I thought I'd sort of insinuate myself generally, you know, kind of play around for a little while, find all the weak spots and shore them up, but with my name played on. You know, become sort of a fact, and then turn into a...
An inevitability.
Yeah, exactly, an inevitability. I'll start by taking over a few classes from the older men, and I'll start some special projects for myself, and I'll plow a few pertinent wives.
Now, that's it. You can take over all the courses you want. You can get as much of the young elite into the gymnasium as you like. But until you start plowing pertinent wives, you aren't really working. The way to a man's heart is through his wife's belly, and don't you forget.
Yeah, I know.
Wait a minute, around here. Are no better than putas. You know those South American ladies of the night, you know what they do down there in Rio, the putas? They hiss at you like geese.
Oh, come on.
I stand around the street and they hiss at you like a bunch of geese.
A gangle.
What?
A gangle of geese, not bunch, gangle.
Well, if you're going to get all cute and ornithological about it, it's gaggle, not gangle. Gaggle.
Gaggle, not gangle?
Yes, gaggle. Oh. Well, they stand around the street and they hiss at you like a bunch of geese. All the faculty wives downtown in New Carthage in front of the A&P hissing away like a bunch of geese. That's the way to power. Plow them all.
Yeah, I bet you're right.
Well, I am.
I bet your wife's the biggest goose in the gangle. I mean, her father being president and all.
You bet your historical inevitability she is.
Well, I just better get her off in a corner and mount her like a goddamn dog, huh?
You'd certainly better.
Hey, I almost think you're serious.
No, baby, you almost think you're serious, and it scares the hell out of you.
Me?
Yes, you.
You're kidding.
I wish I were. I'll give you some good advice if you want me to.
Good advice from you, old boy.
Well, you haven't learned yet. Take it wherever you can get it. Now, listen to
me. Oh, come off
it. I'm giving you good advice.
Good God.
There's quicksand here. You can be dragged down.
Oh, boy.
Before you know it, sucked down.
Oh?
You disgust me on principle, and you're a smug son of a bitch personally, but I'm trying to give you a survival kit.
Ha, ha, ha.
Do you hear me?
Yeah, I hear you. You come in loud.
All right.
Hey, honey!
All right. You want to play it by ear? Right. It's all going to work out anyway because the timetable is history, right?
Right. So you just tend to your knitting, Grandma. I'll be all right.
I've tried to reach you. To
make contact?
Yes.
Yeah, to communicate?
Yes, exactly.
Yeah, well, that's touching. That's downright moving. That's what that is. Up yours.
Hmm?
You heard me?
You take the trouble to construct this civilization, to build a society based on the principles of principle. You endeavor to make communicable sense out of natural order and morality out of the unnatural disorder of men's minds. You make government and art, and you realize that they must be the same thing. And then you reach the saddest of all points, the point where there is something to lose. And then suddenly, through all the music, through all the sensible sounds of men building and attempting, comes the Dies Irae. And what is it? What does the trumpet sound? Up yours. Well, I suppose there's justice to it after all these years. Up yours.
Ha, ha, ha. Bravo, bravo.